Today is Palm Sunday, the beginning of Holy Week, and marks the final days of Jesus' life before his crucifixion. The Bible records that the week began in a celebratory mood as Jesus rode into Jerusalem, flanked by crowds waving palm branches.
Here in the city of Winchester, I'm meeting Christians who are celebrating Palm Sunday. Welcome to Songs of Praise.
Coming up on the programme today, I find out how the people of Winchester reenact Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem.
We have a procession through the high street and we follow a donkey and the choir's there and we've got candles and vestments and it's a lovely public event, people enjoy it.
J.B. Gill meets the street pastors following in Jesus' footsteps by helping the vulnerable and needy.
If you can't look after yourself, somebody is telling you in your ear, I'm the street pastor, you're safe.
And we meet the ex-prisoner who is now a spoken word performer with God at the heart of his verse.
We begin our music today with a hymn that sums up the elation that was felt when Jesus rode into Jerusalem. Fourth Sunday of Lent and is often celebrated with processions and the distribution of blessed palm leaves. Some of those palm leaves are later burned into ashes and used on the Ash Wednesday of the following year. And many Christians fold the palm fronds into crosses like this one to keep.
To find out more, I'm meeting Katherine Ogle, the Dean of Winchester Cathedral.
Dean Katherine, what happened on Palm Sunday?
On Palm Sunday, Jesus entered Jerusalem as its king, and he comes in not on a war horse, but on a donkey. So he's fulfilling ancient prophecies which show that he is the king who's come as the king of love and peace and the king who's a servant. And as he came in, there were great celebrations and people strewed palm leaves and clothes in his path as a sign of humility to him and celebration.
And how do you celebrate Palm Sunday here at Winchester?
We have a procession through the high street and we follow a donkey and the choir's there and we've got candles and vestments and it's a lovely public event. People enjoy it.
I've got lovely memories of going through Neath on Palm Sunday as a chorister, so I used to love that.
Darren Gibb is the head verger here at the cathedral and has been taking part in the parade for nearly 20 years.
So what are we doing here?
We're just setting up for Palm Sunday. So we just put... So on the altars, the nave and the high altar, we put these palm branches.
And you have done the parade here for 20 years
nearly
or something?
20 years, yeah. So we walk all the way down the centre of the high street. Your children go ahead of us and hand out palm crosses. And then we enter the cathedral. Dealing with animals is always a problem, actually. One year, the donkey wasn't playing ball and didn't actually enter the cathedral.
Oh, no.
So
never work with animals.
No, never work with animals, they say, isn't it?
Why do we still celebrate Palm Sunday today?
Palm Sunday is really important because it's the first day of Holy Week, which is the most sacred and significant week of the year for Christians. And so we celebrate Palm Sunday because we remember Jesus coming into his city. And I suppose we're hoping that once again he will come into our hearts and lives.
Lent is a time when people often give something up for 40 days. But one group of Christians give up their time all year round to help their local community.
Inspired by the parable of the Good Samaritan, these Christian volunteers take to the streets at night to help those who need it. JB Gill joined them here in Winchester for a night out with a difference.
Street pastors first appeared in Winchester in 2011. Drawing on Christians from all denominations across the city, they patrol the streets every Friday and Saturday night. Frida has been on the beat for the past 6 years.
So what's going into the bag?
First of all, we put in a flask and some cups and mugs because we give out hot chocolate, soup.
And why do you do that? Why do you do what you do?
Because I think it's important that we look after our own communities, that at 2 o'clock in the morning or 3 o'clock in the morning, if you can't look after yourself, somebody is telling you in your ear, I'm the street pastor, you're safe, mm-hmm. you'll be okay, we'll stay with you.
Pray for each member of the team as they go out tonight.
After a prayer, the city street pastors set off for the night.
We pray that all those with bad intentions stay away.
I join four pastors as they begin their patrol of Winchester's main street, checking in with the door staff at the most popular bars in the town.
Frida, we're out on the streets now.
Yes.
But why have we left two of the team back in the church?
Because they're our prayer pastors, and they're the ones that will pray for us throughout the night. Mm-hmm. And they also have a radio where they can hear what's going on in the city. They have a telephone where one of us will continually ring into them, tell them what's going on.
Shortly after we've set out, we meet a distressed man who wants the pastors to pray for him and his partner.
So Father, we just ask now that you would just really, and that you give them peace in their home together tonight and peace through the rest of the week, this weekend.
We're very comfortable to pray with people if they ask us to. We can offer it if we want to, but we leave people lead that for us.
Street dwellers are well known to the pastors and they are usually thankful of a hot drink and some food.
You need a Twix with that.
You try and keep dry, yeah?
Have a nice weekend.
Yeah, you take care.
They've also comforted distressed nightgoers, helped people to A&E, and even rung up parents to come and pick up their worse-for-wear teenagers. At midnight, the pastors return to base to warm up and discuss what they've seen. They will be out again soon, as their shift doesn't finish until the last bar closes.
It was quite a quiet night tonight in Winchester, but we did have a couple of incidents, didn't we? Do you ever follow up with them?
No. One thing we learned, what happens on the street stays on the street. But obviously, street people, you get to know them over time.
And how does what you do impact on your personal faith?
There's never, ever an evening that I think it's been a waste. Every single time I go, I think, no, maybe we just made somebody's evening a little bit better.
So would you say that you're 21st century Good Samaritans?
It's a lovely way to describe us. I hope so. It's a very nice, very special way to describe us.
Thank you.
church here in Winchester hosted an Easter service with a difference. It included a live spoken word performance that was streamed to over 40,000 prison cells across the country.
I was in a place that I didn't want to be, my face in a mirror that I didn't want to see, no trace of the person I dreamed that I could be. Just another case, a waste, a tragedy.
Lewis Gibson has been writing poetry since he was a teenager, but the catalyst for him starting was an escape from his difficult circumstances.
I've always been sensitive. I take everything to heart, because what's inside and what's outside are miles and miles apart.
I found myself in prison at a very young age. I was in the care of social services through no fault of my parents, really. I did have some behavioural difficulties. I basically spent from the age of 15 to 38 in and out of prison my whole life. I developed addiction problems and substance misuse problems. It started off, you know, normal, you know, going down a pub, drinking, taking recreational drugs, and then heroin was kind of the, was the final destination, really, I suppose. I lost my accommodation and things like that, you know, and I became homeless. I kind of came to this place where I was really broken inside and I was continually coming back to prison. And in that moment, I broke down and I said, God, help me, please.
I was immersed in a dark pool of insanity, sedated with pleasures, drugs, sex and vanity. Coerced like a mule, the carrot in front of me. I wasn't aware that God had a plan for me.
And there wasn't no shining light came down from heaven. It wasn't like that, but I did find comfort in prayer in that moment. And then as I made a firm resolution to get the help that I needed. And going forward, I began to pray on a regular basis. When I was in Winchester Prison, there was a charity called Barefaced Theatre, and they came into the prison and they do a 6-week course, and they provided a platform for me to write some spoken words and actually perform it as well.
Cliff McClelland has been the chaplain at Her Majesty's Prison Winchester for 3.5 years and witnessed that very first performance of Lewis's.
It's really something to have seen it first time round, so to speak. There wasn't a dry eye in the house, and it was quite raw. Because he's lived a lot of time in and out of the prison, and he knows what it is to mess up and end up back inside, he gets what it is to be in their seat, if you like. And so, of course, it resonates with an awful lot of people that are in that constant cycle of in, out, in, out.
So now I'm here and I stand in the light. My passion is fierce and I'm fighting the fight. My conviction is strong and I'm filled with his spirit. I found a new life and with love I will live it.
I try not to dwell on the past, but, and you know, there's a saying in the church, you know, ever looking forward and not back. I prayed for my purpose in prison and, you know, God laid it on my heart that I need to carry a message of hope to people through my spoken words, you know, because I've got a gift here and I do believe it's a gift given from God.
I'm gonna stand up straight, pull back my shoulders. I'm gonna paint that smile on my face. When I'm walking out that door, you're the reason that I've got courage, I've got strength. And the truth, I get a little scared now that we're older. And the truth is, I get a little scared of life without you. You're the one to lift me up if I'm weaker. And the truth is, I feel like I'm alive when I'm with you. We have grown so fast. Some days feel like they're stolen. Trying to make our way through dark uncertainty. I want you to understand that I'll be there anytime you want me to. And the truth is, I get a little scared. Truth is, I get a little scared of life without.
According to data from internet search engines, Psalm 23 is the most searched for psalm online. Also known as the Shepherd Psalm, it's a popular choice for funeral services due to its comforting message and hopeful words. Psalm 23 has also inspired a garden at the Chelsea Flower Show, which we featured on Songs of Praise last summer. Well, that actual garden now has a permanent home here in Winchester. Each plant, flower and stone has made the 66-mile journey from Chelsea and is bringing a smile to the staff, the patients and their families at Winchester Hospice. Hazel Southam is from the Bible Society, who originally commissioned the Psalm 23 garden for Chelsea. The garden is looking amazing. It's just coming into bloom. Can you tell me how each element relates to Psalm 23?
The whole garden embodies the line in the psalm, "He restores my soul." It's a comforting and restorative place to be. But all the way through it, you can see the different elements of the psalm. So the green pastures are just beginning to come to life here. The still waters, but the huge rocks and the somewhat spiky roses represent the valley of the shadow of death. No matter which way you go through this garden, you have to overcome difficulties, rather like life. So it felt like an incredibly appropriate place for the Psalm 23 garden to be.
Maddie Thompson is head of palliative care here at the hospice, and she has noticed the positive effect the new garden has had on the patients.
So you wheel the patients out here?
Yes, so the hospice has been designed such that each doorway is wide enough to allow a bed to be the garden to be accessible by a bed. Patients can be there with their loved ones, their children, they can have their dogs, their pets. It's that opportunity to connect with nature. It's what we call our natural health service. The effect of looking at the movement, the buds, the new life when you're actually facing a period of time towards the end of your life, it provides joy in a what would otherwise be seen as quite a sad time for people.
And does this garden have an effect on your faith?
It does, it does. I suppose most importantly, my faith is very much about serving others and enabling others to seek peace. And this garden accentuates everything.
Someone who has benefited from the words of the psalm and this garden space is Jackie Davis, who lost her husband Jeremy earlier this year.
So Jackie, I know that you witnessed the garden being made here when you were here with your husband Jeremy.
Psalm 23, the main lines were, "Although I walk in the valley of the shadow of death," because that's where we were, because we knew Jeremy was coming to the end of his life. We didn't have to fear any evil. There was nothing to be afraid of. This was a natural process. And he was going to go, and he was going to go to be with the Jesus he loved and be in paradise with God and be free of his pain and everything else that was bothering him and was not nice here. And the garden is new life all the time, because these plants will die down, but they'll come afresh and they'll be beautiful again. And that's, we'll be beautiful again, all of us.
The Lord's my shepherd. He doth restore again, and me to walk doth make. Within the paths of blessedness, e'en for his own name's sake. Within the paths of blessedness, e'en for his own name's sake.
Thank you.
Week to celebrate Easter Sunday, Sean Fletcher visits Holy Island in Northumberland to walk with pilgrims across the sands and to discover why the island has been inspiring Christians for centuries. Well, that's almost it for this Palm Sunday, but before our final hymn, a prayer from some of those we've met today.
Heavenly Father, help us to remember what Jesus did for us, giving his life on the cross. The ultimate sacrifice.
Help us to be like him and help those in need, whoever or wherever they may be.
Thank you for showing us your love and bringing us from the darkest places into the light.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the wonderful words of Psalm 23 and for your promise that you will never forsake us. Amen.